Alan Sempebwa, the Uganda National Roads Authority spokesperson, assured that work had resumed and that repairs are being made. However, he did not provide a specific timeline for when the road will be fully functional again.
The point is, we are spirited at working. I think that for us, the will to work is there. We have not abandoned. When we had challenges with our equipment, we rectified the challenges and brought it back on site. It's not about 3 weeks being enough. It is about what happens during that period of time. Because you see, when we are giving these timelines, we talk about if weather remains favorable, if all other conditions remain favorable, just an anticipated time of completion.
One thing which I must tell you about is that this road, right off from Kahala to Kisoro, the drainage system of this road is very poor. There is no drainage. The maintenance is not there. Because, I mean, where you have seen, where is the passage for water? The drainage system was not properly constructed. That's what, when they are working on maintaining this road, they must think about the drainage system of this road up to Kisoro.
Road users and residents express concerns to UNRA, urging them to effectively repair the road since it is located in a wetland area, posing risks of future destruction.
My prayer, it is to give us good work that we always see maybe somewhere.
Initially, since this road was constructed in 2009, by this time we are supposed to have had a fresh construction of the road, because it is known the period which is granted for such road is supposed to be 3 years and 2 years for repairs. And now we are in the 14th year since the construction. So I will not blame those who constructed, but I will just go back to us as a country.
The Chigezi sub-region in Uganda was severely impacted by recent landslides and floods caused by heavy rains at the beginning of the month. The disasters resulted in the loss of 23 lives, rendered most roads impassable, and caused significant property damage. Report by Job Namaya for the news.